Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for coming today. We made sure that the weather was just perfect, so no worries about that. Actually, really quickly, before we get into the main content today, let me just say we've had such beautiful weather, and it has been a perfect recipe for our lost and found. The cooler mornings and the warm afternoons mean we have a robust lost and found, which I put together on a nice coathanger for you, so when you leave today, if you just want to peek, because I heard it's not going to be so nice over the weekend, you may need some of those layers. Okay, with that formal announcement out of the way, we just want to thank you so much for coming. If we haven't met yet, I'm Quinn, I'm the principal here, and tonight is not about me at all. Tonight is about these wonderful third grade students and the performance they have to honor our veterans, which we have a number of with us in the audience today. Let's just give a round of applause for our veterans. Invited guests today that I'd like to introduce by name and title so we can recognize them and ask them to either stand or wait when I call their name, and we can applaud them for not only their service but spending some time with us this evening. So let me go in this order. Here we have Dutch de Groot, Master Sergeant in the U.S. Air Force, retired U.S. Army. And a link connection as well, helping us connect our veterans to our school community. All right, next we have Ron Belichick, served in the Air Force and is adjutant in the Mount Prospect American Legion Post 515. Thank you, Ron. Next we have John Foster, served in the Navy, Mount Prospect American Legion Post 515. Crew here, we have Bill Starr, Lieutenant Colonel, U.S. Army retired, and the Mount Prospect Post 515. We also have another very special guest, Mary Kay Prustek, our school board member, is here this evening. She had multiple invitations of places to be tonight, and she is here first. I think that speaks volumes. Thank you, Mary Kay. Well, thank you to everyone for being here today. We're going to start with a very special treat from one of our students, Elia, who will be singing the Star Spangled Banner. Let me ask you to rise.
Many of you may know me already. My name is Karen Dahlke. I am main full-time music teacher here at Knife School, and I just wanted to start by welcoming you and introducing our newest Link staff music member. Annie Cho will be conducting our concert tonight, and she is our second music teacher. So all that she teaches on Ms. Morales' class, I teach Ms. Huang's class, but we are there and they will be under Mrs. Cho's direction. So we're ready for it.
On the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month, a piece of ribbon, also known as an armistice, was signed in the year 1918. The following year, President Wilson proclaimed November 11th as Armistice Day.
On May 13th, 1938, Armistice Day became a legal holiday. Since many wars have been fought in our history, it was important to change the word armistice to Veterans Day. On June 1st, 1954, November 11th was officially declared as Veterans Day, a day to honor American veterans of all wars.
Our next selection, Free Love Inc., does just that. We want to thank our veterans for their service to our country.
to the audience, I'm sorry. What I want to say to you is really very simple, and that is that when you say, welcome home, thank you for your service, we appreciate our giving, all of those things that you say to veterans now, it's a popular thing now, but it wasn't. All of you know that World War II ended in July of 1945. All of those guys and women came back in battalions, marching down Main Street, and they were welcomed home, clearly. And it was a beautiful thing. Us veterans, Korean veterans, Vietnam veterans, well, I left the air base in August of 1970, flew over Anchorage, refueled, down to Fort Dix, checked out of the Army in New Jersey, caught a flight to an airfield. I walked through an airfield with my uniform on, dragging my bag. Nobody said a word to me. By the time I got home, I threw my uniform in the closet, shut the door, began the rest of my life. Nobody cared. Nobody said thank you for your service. That was 1970. Now it's different. I want you to know how much we appreciate you appreciating us. So thank you so much.
Next, we will be singing the official song of 1900, "Military Anthem." When you hear your service song,
sing along, the words will be projected on the screen.
Right, there's no Both played their work today for an arts team, letting us have actual practice. Custodial staff and administrators, like the World Record, Ms. Strome, thank you for your support for the arts. Thank you, third graders, for working so hard, even though we missed a lot of Mondays and Halloween and middle school. This is today. Great job, guys. But last but not least, deepest gratitude. Thank you, Banner, for the opportunity to honor you and bless you. Thank you so much. Enjoy your last